Today we're going to learn how to be an inventor in 5 easy steps. Number 1, have an invention idea that people will want to use. Now you'll usually hear people say that an invention needs to solve a problem, but in this day and age, your invention idea can also be entertaining. It can just simply interest people. There's lots of ways to invent something that people will want to use and therefore want to buy. So that's the most important step in this invention process. Number 2, create a detailed description using sketches, photos, detailed drawings, and written descriptions. This is important because you're going to want to talk to other people about your idea. Now, here's a little bit of a warning. The one question you don't ask people is, do they think it's a good idea, or would they buy one if you made them? You're not going to get an honest answer there, and it's really up to you to make that decision. So really you're talking about getting feedback from people about how they like your design, things that they would improve, what they don't like about it. That's always a good thing. Not whether they would buy it or not, just what they don't like about it. Things like the color of it, the types of materials you're using, the overall design and function of the product. Getting feedback from people at this stage can actually be really helpful. And if you notice in the comments section here, there's a lot of people asking me questions about products that they already have invented. And I'm excited about that. That's why I do this channel. So it's fun to talk to these people and hear their thoughts and their dreams, but also give them some realistic feedback as to what they need to do to improve their product. Now this third step is a bit tricky. You're going to need to do a patent search, and it's going to have to be broad enough to make sure that you haven't infringed on other people. I'm not so worried about other people copying your idea at this stage as we are that you're not infringing on someone else. Try to do a keyword search on Google patent search that's broad enough to cover all kinds of variations of your idea. You just want to see what's out there and see what other people have invented so that you're sure you're not stepping on their toes. Let's say you come across something that is really similar to your product and already patented it. Don't get discouraged at this point. Think about other ways to design your product so that it doesn't infringe on anyone's patent. You'd be surprised how easy that is to do, and it'll actually wind up improving your design because honestly, most of the patents out there aren't worth the paper they're printed on. Number 4, you're going to have to start thinking about your prototype. How much it's going to cost, the type of materials you're going to use in the design, the people you're going to need to help you in the design, because I don't expect that you're going to do everything on your own. You are going to need maybe experts in mold making, machining, things like that. You're going to need to think about the design software that you're going to use. I've mentioned Eagle for designing PCBs. I have lots of tutorials on SolidWorks. So you're going to need to start thinking about your design of your prototype and how you're going to do it. Not only are you going to need to save up money, you're going to need to find the people to manufacture your product. If you like what you've been hearing so far, please be sure to subscribe, hit that notification bell, give me a thumbs up, and leave your questions below. So you've made it this far to number 5. Now the hard work really begins. You're going to need to find the money and the resources to build 100 pieces. Now I know this isn't the typical approach that you hear from other inventors, and that's why I'm doing these videos. The reality of it is you don't need to make more than 100 pieces your first time out the gate. You can always ramp up and build more and get the price down later. But the idea here is to minimize your risk in the beginning. And if you think I'm just making this up, I have news for you. Apple Computer was founded with only 100 original Apple I boards. And if you know anything about those boards, they now sell for hundreds of thousands of dollars. It minimizes your risk. So I really want you to think about this hard and make sure you don't follow the advice of people that are telling you that you need to make 100,000 pieces or 10,000 pieces to get started because then it brings the cost down per piece. Yeah, it may bring the cost down per piece, but I got news for you. You're going to spend a fortune. And then what if it doesn't sell? You're going to have a warehouse full of stuff that eventually you're just gonna throw in the dumpster, and you don't want that to happen. So be smart, Think small and work your way up to success. It's easy to do, it's the safe thing to do. And not only that, you can do multiple products in the beginning if you're only doing 100 pieces of each.